For some time I was looking into optimizing my audio system and the Edifier G2000 seemed like a very good choice at its price point. It is supposed to change my butchered Razer Nomo and provide me with a much better alignment under the monitors. Because of its particular features, I was able to fit a car underseat subwoofer quite easily to the system.
Hi mate, so I decided to take a look in another audio equipment which I recently bought. Don't worry that this will be a regular product review. Of course, it is sim racing related because I am installing these speakers on my sim rig. Hi, I'm Stuyo and welcome to my workshop.
So let's start by taking a look into the Edifier speakers. I still cannot understand unboxing videos, but here is one for you. The speakers come in a squarish box. Inside it contains speakers and various other accessories. Everything is wrapped tightly in plastic and it seems Edifier are not so environmental friendly as it's modern these days. I'm used lately when I open a cardboard box to find even more cardboard inside. Oh well, it doesn't matter, everything is still packed very well. All surfaces are very good protected so you don't scratch this nice and shiny finish. One more speaker left unwrapped and we can proceed to the more important stuff. Now let's take a closer look what we get in the box except these nice and small speakers. I particularly like the power supply as it plugs in sideways so you don't block the other sockets on your extension cord. You got also a good quality USB cable as well as a 3.5mm audio jack. Speakers have appealing design, also built-in RGB lighting. Controls are mounted on the side of the right speaker and are easily accessible. Same speaker has all the connectors on the back which are more or less standard except for the main one that is in interest of me, the subwoofer connector. This will allow me to connect external subwoofer pretty easily. I'll use only one jack on the stereo card and it will be controlled natively by the speaker volume controls. Both speakers weigh about 1.5 kg, which makes them particularly suitable to mounting on my motion rig. I would say about now is time to test them and see how they sound. Powering them up produces quite stressful sound. If you keep them in your bedroom and your electricity falls, when it comes up, I am sure you will be awoken. They have 3 built-in audio modes which you can switch between if you feel the need to. I never bothered to test them thoroughly as the speakers sound good as is. Also, they support 3 input modes which would be the audio cable, USB or Bluetooth. They are not auto-switchable but are very nice feature. Here I will play around with the lightning modes which are quite a lot and also they feature a nice breathing effect. My studio lighting makes the colors dull, but the RGB lights are actually quite vibrant and nice to look at in real life. Let's switch some lighting modes now and I will leave you to marvel on the breathing effect and the overall very good look of these compact speakers. First I will connect my phone over Bluetooth as I'm quite eager to hear how they sound. Same as all Bluetooth speakers, the built-in controls operate the volume of your phone. Now let's compare the same thing with my Razer Nomos. Audio tests were almost meaningless as it's very hard to show you how they actually sound with a phone microphone. So let's slowly proceed to something more meaningful. How to actually mount them on the rig. I would be using 2 of my 6 5.1 speaker mounts from TrackRacer. I had a Logitech full surround system previously and they were actually quite handy in mounting it to a rig. This double-sided tape that I'm putting here of course will not mount them securely. I am using it only to keep them in place while I will fix them with something more stable. As always, zip ties come here in handy. The speaker mounts have a lot of holes that you can pass through zip ties and mount the speakers very securely. But why stop here? I will add some hot glue for good measure. It's not very pleasant to the eye and it's not my favorite method of mounting things, but it's easy and as you can see I can put it only on spaces that I wouldn't be able to see when I mount the speakers. Final stage of this preparation would be to trim the zip ties. Once this is complete, we have speakers ready to mount on the rig itself. I have mounted the Edifier speakers to the sim rig and now it's a good time to make some audio tests. As you can see, the speakers are quite compact and they fit pretty nicely next to my wind sim. Overall, I'm pretty happy with this placement and it actually looks quite nice. Of course, these audio tests are quite subjective being shot on phone, but they still give some perspective. So let's start with the Edifier and see how it sounds.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Now let's switch for good measure to Assetto Corsa and start again with the Edifier. It's very hard to hear on phone, but there is definitely a difference. The Edifier is placed below the screen, you can actually hear it better and the same goes as well for me. They are less powerful than razors, but the placements make them sound better. On the other hand, you can clearly see despite the poor positioning of the razors, they had much deeper bass and they are actually more powerful and better sounding. After this totally unmeaningful and somewhat disappointing test, let's move to the fun part. It is time to add a real car underseat subwoofer under the seat of my fake car. This Blaupunkt was the cheapest underseat subwoofer I could find on Amazon and if it's powerful enough for a real car, it definitely is powerful enough for my fake one. It has built-in amplifier and power supply, so you simply plug it to audio source and you had a working subwoofer. Now let's unbox it. No, not really, enough of this nonsense. In the package you find remote control, which is quite standard for these devices, a cable to connect it through an audio source and power with built-in fuse and not so full manual, but with wiring instructions at least. And of course, the main unit, the Blaupunkt subwoofer. For a 150 watts rated subwoofer system, it actually is quite compact. It should easily fit under most car seats. As I will be putting it on board of the motion rig, it's quite interesting to see how much it actually weighs. 3.7 kilos of added weight. Installation of the subwoofer will start by connecting all the cables. The power cable comes with a Molex connector which simply plugs in beneath the subwoofer. It also features an inline fuse which is close to the power supply, which is as it should be. Then we simply plug in the remote and place the retention bracket, screw it in to hold everything in place. And that's it on this side of the woofer. To connect to the speakers, you would need a RCA to 3.5 mm audio cable, which is not included. And for power supply, you would need 12 volts. Cable connection and installation is not something that I will show you, so I will proceed to mounting the support brackets. The Blaupunkt comes with mounting brackets, which are intended to be directly screwed into the bedliner of your footwells, but I will not be using them. Instead, I simply drilled two holes on these 3030 series aluminium extrusions. Each of them is long 20 cm and I screw them to the bottom of the subwoofer. You need to put a washer beneath them as the grooves for the brackets are recessed so they are not on the same level as the bottom of the box. Then simply add some angle brackets and the woofer is ready to be mounted on the rig. And here is when I mounted it right below the seat. The other option would be under your pedal plate. I power it together with my shaker system from a 600 watt supply, which gives 24 volts, and then a step down to 12. And now time to test the complete system with both music and in-game footage. So, what is the outcome of all of this? The Edifier speakers are quite powerful device for its size. They are not matched for my Razer Nomos, but they are close enough for this application. They support USB, audio input and Bluetooth, also have very nice lighting. They are quite cheap system, but they are on par with much more expensive ones. Interesting thing about them is that at full volume they don't have much distortion and sound is still clear and crisp. Overall, they are great package and for compact sound system, they are a no-brainer. They even have sound for much more expensive speakers than they what really are. One of the great features they have is the built-in subwoofer output, which leads me in to the next topic. Edifier also sell 2.1 system with these speakers paired with their own subwoofer, but I opted for a car audio one. This Blaupunkt model was the cheapest one integrated car audio subwoofer that I could find on Amazon, which has power supply and amplifier built in. It is meant to go under your car seat, so it's quite compact package. I put it behind my seat because this was the easiest place I could have accessed and it was the fastest installation possible. Another great option would be to put it under your pedal plate. It is rated at 150 watts and it actually is quite a powerful device. I have the same sized one in the trunk of my car and I have been happily using it for years. I wonder how this translates in sim racing context? Well, I will tell you now. This placing under my seat, which is not ideal, but it was the quickest one, I am able to feel all the engine vibrations coming from the subwoofer like I have a real bar shaker mounted there. The vibrations from the subwoofer coming to the seat are on par with the Aura bar shakers I have mounted directly on the seat. Downside of this, that it's actually noisy as it's audio subwoofer and it's supposed to be. Actually, mounting one of those under your pedal plate would be the best place on the rig and you will get very convincing engine vibrations. The subwoofer itself was not particularly loud as it's a small system and it was quite tolerable. Audio quality for both systems was much better than I expected. With underscreen placement of the Edifier speakers, I am now able to hear much more sound detail, so it's much better spot than on top of the monitors. Was it worth it? Well, you decide, but I certainly had fun with this system.